In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad, of 1400 years ago, is the last messenger, servant, and prophet to the world. As I greet you in the greeting words of peace, we say it in the Arabic language, the universal greetings of As-Salaam Alaikum, and we add wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh, which means in English, may the peace and mercy and blessings of Allah be upon you. My short topic is called Slipping Through the Cracks. And what do I mean by this? If we had a foundation to a house and the foundation had cracks in it, we would say that the water is slipping or seeping through the cracks of the foundation, which is creating a bigger crack that eventually will break down the foundation, and eventually the house will sink and eventually cave in. As we look around our communities, we can see that there is cracks all throughout the black community. There are cracks within the black community and in the households. In these cracks, there is slipping Satan, the slippery Satan, that is causing our people to slip from the right path. And where are these cracks at? If we are in a war, we have to identify exactly where the enemy is. So in identifying exactly where the enemy is, they send in spies to be amongst the people so they can find out exactly where to pinpoint the place to shoot the missile or to attack. And where is it that the place of entrance into the hearts and minds of our people that is causing them to slip from the Sirat al-Mustaqim, as we say in Arabic, the straight path of God? They are slipping. They are creeping in through the cracks of the television. Look at the way the language has changed through over the years in the television. Just think of the people that control the television, control the information that comes over the airways that the children see, the children hear, and that the children pick up and go after and model. Who are these people that are allowing this language upon the airways of America? They have changed the language to disgraceful language, saying the B word on television, which is a female dog according to the dictionary, saying other language that were considered extremely bad to say on TV, extremely bad for young people to hear and pick up. What kind of people are allowing this over the airways like this? It's Satan. They can be billionaires. They can be millionaires. But they have the power to put these things over the airways so that the population can pick it up and put it within their lives to cause destruction upon destruction. Because there is a secret plan in place to produce a society of killers, a society of prostitutes, a society of slaves. And what are you doing to fill in the cracks so that this filth does not seep in? You know, when your foundation is messed up, you call foundation people that can fix and repair your foundation. Who are the people out here that are trying to fix and repair the damage that has been done to our people through the American system? We find nobody doing it better than the brothers and sisters that are in the Nation of Islam, the FOID and MGT. Repairing the cracks in the foundation so that the water won't seep in, the filthy water won't seep in, to open the crack bigger so that the house will fall. We have brothers and sisters that have the real truth of what is going on in our society, in our homes, in the nation, in the world. And Satan tries his very best to create a false image of those that really have the truth that we need in this time and hour to fix the cracks in the foundation. And that foundation is proper knowledge of self, proper knowledge of God, proper knowledge of the devil. Once this full understanding of self, of God, and the devil is known, then the foundation will start to be patched up. And we can repair the damage that has been done to us by America, and that we do even more upon ourselves. The brothers and sisters are here. Only if you would listen. Only if you would stop listening to the liars saying this, they are racist. They are haters of white people. They are everything other than righteous. But you know how the saying goes. You a Muslim? You know you don't supposed to be doing that. You a Muslim? You know you don't supposed to be doing this or that. So what are they saying? What are you saying to us? You are saying that we know that you have some type of superior morals, superior way of being. That's not said to Christians. That's not said to other religious people that, you know you don't supposed to be doing it. You a Muslim? You know you don't supposed to be doing it. Because there's a recognition amongst the people of what, who, and how we supposed to be, and that it's something more superior than what the Christians are speaking and what others are speaking. Because there has been no one that has cleaned up the community like the brothers and sisters in the Nation of Islam. No one. If you go back in history and see the history of the work of the brothers and sisters, you cannot say that the brothers and sisters did not have one of the greatest impacts on black life than anyone else. because it is the nation of Islam that has had the greatest impact and the greatest hatred and conspiracy come against us by the government and these silly Uncle Toms. But the brothers and sisters are here to give you the knowledge, the truth, not to babysit you, but to give you the knowledge and the truth so that you can get up, lace up your own bootstraps, go to work, and do something for yourself. And to pull us, you and I, up out of the mud of ignorance and want and poverty and hatred of self and kind. To put us upon that Siddhartha Mustaqim. To give us paradise at once. As I greet you as I came, we say it in the Arabic language of Assalamu Alaikum. And we add, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Which means in English, may the peace and mercy and blessings of Allah be upon you.